See this. I have already completed two units, unit 1 and unit 2. Okay, see this. Unit 1 covers the concepts of mechatronics like elements, levels, and mechatronics design process, control systems, measurement systems, micro-based controllers, everything we have covered in first unit. And along with the basics of the mechatronic systems, we have also learned about sensors and different types of sensors, their working principles, and that is about the first unit. And in second unit, we have completed different types of electronic devices like PN junction diode, bipolar junction transistor, field effect transistor, diode, AC current switch, triode AC current switch, okay, LEDs, light emitting diodes, and also completed about analog signal conditioning, means about operational amplifiers and different types of filters. Okay, this is about first unit and second unit. And from today onwards, we will start a new unit, that is third unit. Okay, see this slide. I think you remember this slide. Anyone? What is the slide? Hello, please unmute. Anyone, please respond. What is about slide? It shows
second unit starting with paper gas.
Adhe entamma idi. What is this?
Mechanical system sample.
What we call?
Devices, sir. Electronic.
No, no. All these are the elements of mechatronic system.
Hello.
All these are the elements of the mechatronic system. Now you remember this flow chart, this chart represents the elements of mechatronic system. Okay, in this mechatronic system, these are the elements. What are those? Sensors, actuators, signal conditioning, and controller. Okay, and displays, graphical displays. Okay, so our total syllabus is just the elements. Different, we are learning about different elements of the mechatronic system. Here we have already completed about sensors and signal conditioning processes. So what are the remaining? Actuators are there, digital control architecture is there, and remaining controllers are there. So our next element of mechatronic system is actuators. Okay, we have completed sensors and signal conditioning up to now. Now we'll start discussing about actuators. Okay, next chapter, next unit is about actuators. Okay, this is our third unit syllabus. Now see the syllabus of third unit. What is it? Comprises the actuating system, different types of actuating systems we'll discuss here. Okay, what are the actuating systems? Hydraulic actuating systems and pneumatic actuation systems. Those are the first two topic in this unit, that is hydraulic and pneumatic actuating systems. Here we learn, okay, what are the components and working principle of the actuating systems, and what are the components used in actuating system and control valves, okay, in hydraulic and pneumatic actuating systems. It also cover electro pneumatic, hydro pneumatic, and electro hydraulic systems. So here we learn hydraulic systems, pneumatic systems, and the components used in these systems, and control valves used in these systems, and along with electro pneumatic, hydro pneumatic, and electro hydraulic servo motor systems also learn in this unit. And also covers this unit also covers mechanical actuating systems and electrical actuating systems. Okay, total unit covers the different types of actuating systems used in mechatronic system. So this is about third unit. Okay, we will learn one by one. Okay, this is not related to electronic subject. This is our own subject, that is related to our mechanical, and especially related to fluid mechanics and hydraulic machines. I think you just remind all those things. Okay, now I will start the third unit. The first topic is hydraulic and pneumatic actuating systems. What is actuator? You know. Okay, sensors are the sensors means they convert mechanical signal to electrical signal. But while controlling a machine, okay, or any system, we need to apply mechanical force. Okay, but controllers gives the output of the controllers is the electrical signal. Okay, you have to convert that electrical signal into mechanical signal. Okay, that mechanical signal, that is nothing but actuators, means they convert the electrical signal into mechanical signal, means low grade signal into high grade signals, means these actuators creates mechanical force which are required to control a machine or a system. Means actually the actuators are the controllers, they control the process or industry, any machine or system. Okay, here it is the reverse to the sensors. Sensors get the information and they suggest the correction to control system. Control systems gives the corrections to actuation system. Actuation, real implementers are actuating systems. They implement the control signals coming from the controller. Okay. Now we see one by one. The first one is fluid power systems. Fluid power system. What is fluid? Okay. The substance which has the ability to flow is nothing but fluid. Fluid comprises two things, liquids and gases. Already we have learned in FMHM subject. Okay, here the main motto of the fluid system is to convert. Okay, here the working medium is fluid, either liquids or gases. Okay, here fluid power is nothing but the utilization of liquids or gases as a media for transmission of energy, means the energy is transferred in terms of fluids, means hydraulic energy is converted into mechanical energy, or pneumatic energy is converted into mechanical energy. Here the energy transmission is done by fluids. Here fluids are the medium, working medium in this fluid power systems. Okay, so here we have two types of, you can classify the fluid power systems into two types. One is hydraulic systems, second one is pneumatic system. Okay, in hydraulic system the liquids are the medium, working medium, means we are using the liquids like oil, water, whatever it is. And in pneumatic systems the working medium is air. We are using air as a medium for transmission of energy from one form to another form. So fluid systems comprises two, that is hydraulic systems and pneumatic systems. Now the main purpose of these fluid power systems is three. We have three uses. The one is carrying out mechanical work. What is the first use of the fluid power systems? Is carrying out mechanical work, means we have to do some mechanical work. For doing that mechanical work we need to apply some mechanical force. That is done by fluid power systems. Okay, means we can do some work with the help of fluid power systems, either hydraulic systems or pneumatic system, whatever it is, we can do some work with the help of these systems. Means we can get different motions like linear motion, civil motion or rotary motion. Okay, means we can do any work, we can move in different way. Already you know, one of the known example is JCB. Okay, we can control and we can apply the force to the arm with the help of hydraulic systems. Here we have different applications, for doing mechanical work, such as clamping, shifting, positioning, packing, feeding, drilling, turning. We have different operations can perform by using fluid power systems. Okay, all these operations required mechanical force that can be applied by using these power systems, either hydraulic or pneumatic. And the second use is controlling applications, means we control the motion or any operation by using these fluid power systems. Means we can control the movement, we can control the force, and we can control whatever it is. We can control that particular process or equipment or machine by using fluid power systems. That is the second use of the fluid power systems. You know, in JCB, already I have given an example, that is JCB. In JCB, the arm of the JCB is controlled with the help of hydraulics. Okay, suppose take pneumatic brakes. Okay, the brakes means the movement of the vehicle can be controlled with the help of pneumatic brakes. Okay, what is the medium? Air brakes, means air is the medium. Okay, and hydraulic brakes means we can control the motion of the body with the help of hydraulic system, means we can control the speed, we can control the force, we can control the movements, everything. Okay, by using this fluid power system, that is the second use of the this system. And third use, measurement of process parameter. Okay, means this provides some measurement process parameters. Okay, means we can measure the process parameters by using these systems. These systems provide the information and necessary actions to be taken for the information according to the information. Okay, means these power systems also used as measurement for different process parameters. Okay, by using these systems we can measure the process parameters like displacement or velocity or acceleration, whatever it is. Okay, we can get that information through these systems, and according to the information given by the system is we are taking the necessary action, that is necessary output. Okay, these are the three main uses of the fluid power systems. What are these? It applies mechanical work, mechanical force, and it do some mechanical work, and it controls, okay, some process or machine, whatever it is, and it also provides the information measurement, okay, to the system, okay, for correction or for controlling the system. These are the three uses of the fluid power systems. Next one, these are the applications, industrial applications of the different fluid power systems. Already I told JCB. Okay, this is the one of the example here. Working medium is to control the arm is fluid hydraulics. This is the jack for lifting the vehicles. Okay, we are using hydraulic jacks. Here also working medium is hydraulics. This is the ram. Okay, we can use both hydraulic and pneumatic. Okay, for controlling the ram lift. Okay, lift also operated with the hydraulic lifts are there, pneumatic lifts are there. Okay, these are the industrial applications. And suspension system in aircrafts, we can use the hydraulics as a suspension system, hydraulics or pneumatics. And hydromobiles also, we can use hydraulics and pneumatics as a suspension system. We can use as a brakes, hydraulic brakes as a pneumatic brakes. And for braking system also, we are using fluids. Okay, and industries also for movement of different heavy equipments, we are using hydraulics and pneumatics. And even metal testing also in UTM. Okay, we have a UTM in our college, in SM lab. That is also hydraulically operated testing machine. And for lifting the truck, we are applying the force by using hydraulics and pneumatics, whatever it is. So these are the few known applications of fluid power systems. Okay, here we are doing some work with the help of this fluid power systems. Means they convert energy one form to other form. Means it converts hydraulic energy into mechanical energy. Okay, these are the applications of the systems. Next we see one by one. First one is hydraulic systems. Okay, hydraulics means here we are using liquids, liquid-based solutions. Okay, as a working medium, such as oils. Especially we are using oil as a working medium. Okay, here the oil under pressure is used to carry out the work. Okay, now we see how hydraulic system is working. Okay, later I will show this. Any hydraulic system, we have a basic element, that is hydraulic actuator. It is nothing but is a cylinder and piston arrangement. Here we have a piston. Okay, the piston is connected to the load. Okay, here this is a cylinder. We have two ports. If you connect the fluid hydraulics oil to this port, okay, the pressure of oil lift this piston to upwards. Okay, if you apply fluid in this direction, it lower down this load. Means the upward and downward movement of the piston is done by fluid. Okay, fluid means here oil. Okay, means we are converting the pressure, means hydraulic energy is converted into mechanical force. Mechanical energy means upward and downward motion of the weight. Okay, now I will show the hydraulic system. These are the basic elements of the hydraulic system. Any hydraulic system consists of these basic elements. What are the elements? This is the storage tank. Okay, and we have a filter, okay, to remove the contaminants, means solid particles which are coming from the reservoir. Okay, the filtering oil is moving towards pump. Means what is the use of pump? Okay, pump converts mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. Pump converts mechanical energy into hydraulic energy means it sucks the oil and it gives some pressure. Means the pressurized oil is pumping towards circuit. Okay, this pump is run by motor. Okay, this is the next element. And here the pump is pumping the fluid with certain pressure. If the pressure is high, means the pressure is more than preset value, it may damage either pump or piping system. So we have to regulate the pressure. So here we have a pressure relief valve. Okay, if we send fluid with high pressure, means the pressure is more than preset value, okay, it releases some fluid to tank. Means for reducing the pressure, okay, it's just spills the fluid into the tank. Okay, next, after pressure regulator, the hydraulic oil is entering into the valve. This is the direction control valve. It directs the oil to the upward of the piston and downward of the piston. If the fluid is moving upward, the piston is moving towards down. If fluid is entering into the downward, okay, piston is moving to the up. I will show a video. This is the hydraulic system. Hydraulic system. See the video. These are the elements of the hydraulic system. Here, this is the overhead tank. Sorry, this is the reservoir, oil reservoir. Okay, this is the pump. There is a filter between the pump and oil, means hydraulic fluid. Now, the main purpose of filter is to remove the contaminants or dust from this tank. Okay, it pumps is used for convert the mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. See this, the working. Here three positions. This is off position. Okay, this is rise position. This is lower position. If the lever is at middle, it is an off. Lower position, see this. Okay, the fluid which from the bottom of the piston is moving towards reservoir. Okay, and the fluid above, okay, is entering into the above the piston. Means the fluid entering into the above the piston and the fluid below the piston is removed and sent to the reservoir. See this. This is done by direction control valve. Second, rise means the fluid is entering below the system. Okay, here the port is opened. Here the port is return port to reservoir. Okay, means okay, in one direction we are filling the oil, in other direction we are drawing the oil towards reservoir. Okay, by using this direction control valve, okay, we can change the direction of the oil towards down or upward up of the piston. See this. This is the working of the hydraulic system. Now suppose the lever is at center position, this is off position. Okay, lower means the fluid is moving, entering into the above the system, and below the system the fluid is moving towards reservoir. Rise position means the fluid is entering into the lower part of the cylinder, and upper part we are drawing the oil towards reservoir. This is the working of the hydraulic system. Okay, see this. Here you know that is Pascal's law. What is the Pascal's law? In a hydraulic static condition, the pressure in all directions is equal. That is P1 is equal to P2. That is equal to F2 by A2 is equal to F1 by A1. Okay, here suppose the cylinder is circular, so pi by 4 d square means pi pi cancel. Now the force, okay, is equal to F1 into D2 square by D1 square. Okay, here by using hydraulic system, we can lift heavy weights also. If you apply 150 bar pressure, you can lift 2000 kgs, means 2 tons of the 2 tons can be lifted with the help of 150 bar. Okay, with the help of 4.2 centimeters piston. Okay, we can lift 2000 kgs at 150 bar pressure. Okay, means we can lift higher loads with the help of hydraulic system. You know, this is hydraulic press. This represents the Pascal law. Okay, here F1 is different, F2 is different, but pressure is same at any point. Means P2 is equal to P1, and F1 by A1 is equal to F2 by A2. That is Pascal law. Already you know that. Okay, already physical components we have seen this. Any hydraulic system consists of reservoir, filter, pump, motor, pressure regulator, control valve means direction control valve, and an actuator. This is the actuator. Actuator is nothing but piston cylinder assembly. Okay, the movement of the piston in the cylinder is controlled by, okay, liquid oil. Okay, and that one is operated by direction control valve. Here we have two ports, A port and B port. Okay, the oil, the direction of oil through A or B is decided by direction control valve. Okay, that one decided according to lowering or rising of the piston here. This is a hydraulic system. This is the hydraulic power system. Okay, this is the real shape. This is the reservoir, motor, pump, and these are the input output pipes, and we have pressure gauges also. Okay, this is the real type of hydraulic power systems. Okay, and we can control the speed of the piston, means the movement of the piston, upping and rising. The speed of the piston can also controlled by using this hydraulic system, by using this relation. Velocity is equal to flow rate by, okay, area, means by controlling the flow rate, we can control the velocity. We can control the velocity, means if you can send the fluid with high velocity, the movement of piston also rises. Okay, if the flow rate is less, the velocity of piston also decreases, because the velocity of piston is depending on the flow rate of the oil. Okay, next one, this is about hydraulic system. Next one is pneumatic system. Second one is pneumatic system. Okay, here the working medium is gas. Okay, pneumatic means yes, especially that is air. Air is used as working medium for operating these pneumatic systems. Okay, you know, air is the compressible fluid. Air is the compressible fluid, and oil is the incompressible fluid. Already you learned in previous classes or in previous years. Okay, now you know air is the compressible fluid, means we can compress the air to any volume by applying the pressure. Okay, now we see the different elements of the pneumatic system. Here also we have cylinder and piston. All the, I think you have seen pneumatic equipment in our Weldon lab. I think you have operated, am I right or not? I don't know. I think you have seen all those pneumatic operating devices in Weldon lab. Okay, here also we have a piston and cylinder arrangement. This is the actuator, pneumatic actuator. Need here the power source is compressor. Okay, here instead of pump, here we have a compressor. Okay, the main purpose of the compressor is to compress the air from the environment, okay, atmosphere. Here this compressor is run with the help of a engine or motor. Here motor is used to run the compressor. Okay, we have different types of compressor. Later we will discuss about types of compressors. And the compressor is moving towards air receiver. This is the tank, air tank, I think you know. Okay, here the compressed air is stored in this air receiver. Okay, here a pressure switch, which is controlled by a motor control, is there. Motor means if the pressure inside the tank is increases, okay, it may damage the air receiver. So we have to release the pressure. So if the pressure in this tank is increases, the pressure switch operates it controls the speed of the motor that will reduce the pressure generated by the compressor. Then the pressure inside the tank is reduced. So here we have a controlling system to control the pressure inside the air receiver. Next, from the air receiver, we have a direction control valve like previous section. Okay, here it directs the air. If the air is directed towards upward of the system, the movement of the piston is downward. Okay, if air is entering into the below the system, okay, it raises the piston towards up. Means, and the air in the other side is released to atmosphere because air is free. So no need to store again. So this is a open circuit. But in hydraulics, we need to send the oil towards reservoir. That is closed system. This is the open system. We are relieving the air from the other side of the piston. So according to the movement of the piston, we are operating the valve, and that valve directs the air towards bottom of the system and top of the system according to the movement of the piston towards up or down. That decides the direction control valve. These are the elements of the pneumatic system: compressor, motor, air receiver, direction control valve, and actuator. Here we have some valves also. Okay, we will see some filters. All we needed some filters. Okay, later I will explain the those filters. Okay, this is the real type of pneumatic system. This is the compressor. This is operated by a motor. This is the air receiver. Okay, this is our pressure gauge. We can control the pressure by the reading, and we can connect the total equipment to the control system. Okay, which we have to control it. See this video. Here we have a filter to filter the air. Okay, this filters the dust or particles from the air which are not moving towards pipe. Okay, this is the compressor. Okay, this is the air treatment. Okay, we have a filter here. We have to treat the air. Later I will explain. Next, air receiver is this. Storage is nothing but air receiver. And this is the direction control valve. Here the piston, the movement of the piston is controlled with the help of direction control valve. Okay, here the motor is there, and we have a connection between the air receiver and the motor, because we have to control the pressure inside the air receiver. For that purpose, we can increase or decrease the motor speed to regulate the pressure inside the air receiver. Okay, suppose the air is moving downwards, it is rising. The air up in upward chamber, that is, leaves to atmosphere. Okay, and lowering and rising of the piston is like, if suppose the lever is at middle, that is idle condition. See this. This is the downward movement. The air from this bottom is trapped towards environment. This is about pneumatic system. Okay. Here we are using air as a medium. Okay. Here we need a treatment, a primary air treatment. Means here we need a cooler or a filter, a separator. Means if there is any, okay. Wetness in the air, we have to remove that. Is there any mist? We have to remove that. For that purpose, we have separator. Okay, and we need to remove the dust from the air. For that purpose, we have some filters. Later, we will discuss about all components which are used in the pneumatic system and hydraulic system. Okay, see this. This is the schema block diagram of elements of the pneumatic system. Already explained. Air is atmosphere is coming towards filter. Filter filters the air and compressor. Okay, and we have a treatment, primary air treatment. I will explain later about air treatment. Next, air receiver. Okay, and we have a regulator. We have a feedback from the air receiver to motor for controlling the pressure inside the air receiver. Next, secondary treatment and direction control valve and a pneumatic actuator. Okay, near we have a small comparison between the hydraulics and pneumatics. Okay, first we see the disadvantages and advantages of the fluid systems, then we compare the hydraulic and pneumatics. Okay, our battery is down. Okay, don't worry, until shutdown I will continue, later I will continue through a phone. Okay, comparison, here we have availability. Okay, you know the availability of air is very high, so and we can, and the cost of the oil and water also less when compared, so the availability of working medium is good. And second one, transport. Okay, you can take air at anywhere, and the transportation of hydraulic fluids also easy from one place to another place. And storage, we can store the air, but storage of air is somewhat difficult, still we have managed. Okay, and hydraulic oil, we can we have special tanks to store the hydraulic oils. Okay, next, temperature. Okay, I think air, compressed air is relatively sensitive to temperature fluctuations, but hydraulic fluids are relatively insensitive. Means if I increase the both air and oils, transport is easy for oils, and air means you can take air for at anywhere. Storage is easy for, you can store the both air and oil. And temperature means the air properties of the air is changed with respect to temperature. Okay, when compared with the hydraulic fluids. And explosion means air is safe, there is no much risk. Okay, but oils are somewhat dangerous, because there is a possibility for explosion or fire with hydraulics. And cleanness. Okay, the device is also very clean. For if your pneumatics are some devices, those are very clean. If the components used in oil means somewhat dirty, but we can maintain the cleanness. Okay, and components which are used in pneumatic are simple. Okay, but and relatively cheap when compared with the hydraulics. Okay, next, speed. Okay, compressed air and hydraulic fluids are very fast working mediums. When compared with the hydraulics, we can operate the systems with pneumatics is high speed. And adjustable. Okay, means we can adjust the speed and force by hydraulics and pneumatics. These are the advantages of the mean pneumatic and different characteristics of the pneumatic and hydraulic systems. Okay, disadvantages. Okay, preparation means compressed air hydraulic fluid require good preparation, means we have to remove the dirt and condensate. And compressible, it is not possible to achieve uniform and constant piston speeds with pneumatic systems, because air is a compressible fluid, that's why it is not possible to achieve uniform and constant piston speed, but in hydraulics we can maintain that. And force requirement. Okay, compressed air is economical only when working pressure is 6 to 7 bar only. If the pressure is increases, we have to go for hydraulics. Means we can't maintain the pressure more than 7 bar by using pneumatics. Okay, noise level. Noise is very high in pneumatics when compared with the hydraulics. And cost. Compressed air and hydraulic fluids are relatively expensive means of conveying power. However, the operating cost of the hydraulic system is less than compressed air. Okay, this is a comparison. I will show one table. This will explains about the difference between the hydraulics and the pneumatics. Okay, see this. Energy source means we can run the both hydraulics and pneumatics by using electrical motor or engines, diesel engines. Okay, running. Okay, it needs cooler, means hydraulic. Okay, needs cooler. Okay, it runs cool. There is no need of cooler here. Pneumatic. Space, hydraulic is compact. This is most compact. Okay, transport, limited, basically local. Okay, plant wide and easy, because air is available at any place. Energy cost, this is medium, this is highest. Availability, limited, unlimited. And force application, very high force can be possible with hydraulics. Okay, medium force can be possible in pneumatics. And cleanness, very clean, hydraulics. Okay, missile, definitely there will be some leak, because this is air. And speed of operation, this is operated at low speed. Here we can maintain high speeds, means air brakes, already there is a cousin. Okay, at the back side of the vehicles, we have to maintain some distance, because air brakes. Okay, means operation is very fast. Safety, there is a chance for fire because oil, but this is explosion proof, means air, there is no explosion means this is safe because we are using air. Noise level, less noise, but here noisy because air leakage is quite noisy. Temperature, this is insensitive, pneumatic is sensitive. These are the advantage comparison between the various parameters between hydraulic systems and pneumatic systems. Okay, see this. Energy source means we are using motor or diesel engine to run the hydraulic systems. At the same, pneumatic systems also operated with the help of electrical motors or diesel engines. Okay, see this slide. So most of the hydraulics is the it has some best applications. According to application, we can choose the hydraulic systems or pneumatic systems according based on this parameter. This is the comparison between hydraulic systems and pneumatic systems. I think you have some idea about these hydraulics and pneumatics. I think so much explanation is not needed. If you can see, you can understand these things. Okay, means we can uptime, we can maintain 150 bar pressure also, but by using pneumatics, so the pressure is below 10 bar. Is more than 10 bar, we can't maintain it. Okay, up to this. Okay, next one. System structure and signal flow. System structure and signal flow means there is a different levels. Means we can break the total fluid power systems into different elements, different levels. Based on that levels, we have some signal flow is there. We see that structure of this fluid power systems. Here we have four levels: energy source, input elements, processing elements, and actuators. Now we see the flow here, signal flow in the pneumatic systems or hydraulic systems, whatever it is, signal flow in the fluid power system. See here, first one, what is the basic one? We need some energy supply. Okay, mean in case of hydraulics, we need pump to supply the, it converts the mechanical power into mechanical energy into, okay, hydraulic energy. Okay, in case of pneumatics, we need compressor. It converts the mechanical energy into pneumatic energy. So this is the energy supply. Okay, next one, input elements comprises control valves, limiting switches, push buttons, sensors. Means for controlling the system, we need some input elements. Okay, these are operation of these input elements can cause the operation of the system. Next, processing elements. These are the input elements, control valves like this. Okay, here we have processing elements. Processing elements means direction control valve. It is a processing elements means it operates, it directs the fluid, okay, according to the operation of the movement of the piston. And logic elements, pressure control valve, flow control valve, all these are processing elements. Next one, final control element means this is here also we have direction control valve, the final element which decides, okay, movement of the piston. And what is the top? That is actuating device. That is the actuating device, either hydraulic actuator or pneumatic actuator. Actuator is nothing but the assembly of piston and the cylinder, is nothing but actuating device. The actuator is operated by fluid. Okay, that one decided by final control element. Okay, before that we have some processing element is there, and before that we have some input elements, and before that we are supplying some energy. This is the flow of signal. Here the signal carrying element is fluid, either liquid or oil, whatever it is. Here the signal carrying element is fluid. Okay, this is the flow of signals from bottom to top. Okay, this is about signal flow in the fluid systems. Okay, now we see the different components of the fluid systems. Now we see the different components of fluid systems. Okay, first we see the hydraulic components in the hydraulic system. You know, what are the components in hydraulic systems? Pump, pressure regulator, filters, control valves. Okay, these are the main elements, components in the hydraulic system. Now we see one by one. What is pump? What are the different types of pumps? And what is pressure regulator? And what is filter? And what are the different valves used for controlling the flow of hydraulic liquids. Okay, now we see the components of the hydraulic system. Okay, first one is pumps. Okay, from next class I will continue this. At the time now 12:45, we have 5 minutes more. Okay, I will continue. Hydraulic pumps, you know what is hydraulic pump? First component, the main component of the hydraulic system is pump. Okay, what is a pump? Pump is a device that converts mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. Pump is a device that converts mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. Hydraulic energy means it creates some head, means it lifts. Okay, means it moves the fluid from lower pressure to higher pressure, means it moves the fluid from lower head to higher head, means it pressurizes the fluid. So the pump is convert the mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. Hydraulic energy is nothing but pressure. In terms of pressure, we are using that pressure for applying the mechanical force in actuators. Okay, we have different types of pumps. The mainly the pumps are classified into two types. Okay, hydraulic means hydrodynamic pumps and force to displacement pumps. Okay, this is the symbol of pump. Any pump, we have a motor, we need a motor, okay, to run the pump. Here we have two types of pumps, that is hydrodynamic pump and positive displacement pumps. I have already explained in FMHM. I think how many members are remember that, but I will give a small idea on this. Hydrodynamic pump means centrifugal pump. Okay, next, positive displacement pump means reciprocating pump. We have different types of positive displacement pumps used in the industries. Okay, I will explain one by one. Okay, first we see the hydrodynamic pump. See, a centrifugal pump. Okay, that is comes under hydrodynamic pump. Here we have different parts. You know that what are the parts of a centrifugal pump? We have impeller and casing. Okay, and we have a suction pipe and delivery pipe. Here the motor is connected to the impeller. It rotates the impeller, that creates, okay, some hydraulic head, means it creates some vacuum there. Because of that, we can lift the water from lower level to higher level, means the rotation of the impeller is converted into centrifugal force. Because of the centrifugal force, the fluid is lifting towards delivery pipe. Okay, that's why it is called centrifugal pump. I think you know the working of the centrifugal pump. This is already known. Okay, and next one is positive displacement pump. Positive displacement pump, because displacement means we are displacing some amount of fluid from suction side to delivery side. That is called the displacement of fluid. Okay, here in every cycle, means for every rotation of the crank, we are delivering certain amount which is filled in this piston cylinder, means we can lift the, we can displace the fluid the according to the volume of this cylinder. Okay, for every cycle we are lifting constant volume to delivery pipe. That's why it is called a positive displacement pump, because we are always displaces the fluid from lower level to higher level. Even you switch off this pump, still there is the movement of the fluid is towards delivery pipe only. There is no return of the fluid from delivery to suction. But in case of hydrodynamic pump, if you stop this pump, the fluid in this casing are reversed towards suction, means the fluid is displaced in reverse manner. If you stop the rotation of the impeller, only the fluid is displacing towards positive while the impeller is rotating. That's why it is called negative displacement pumps. Means only in on condition only these pumps are displaces the fluid towards delivery pipe. If you off the pump, the fluid in this casing is to reverse towards suction. That's why it is called negative displacement. Here positive displacement, always the fluid is entering from lower to higher, means always towards delivery pipe only. Okay, we have different types of positive displacement pumps. The best one is gear pump. Already time is over. Okay, I will continue later.